Hello friends, in this video we'll be starting with the new topic linear programming problems, that is LPP, and we'll see basic problem. Welcome back friends, let us start with the new chapter LPP, that is linear programming problems. What do you mean by linear programming problems? See here, a problem is given to us. This is the problem. And this problem is of LPP, that is linear programming problems. Now, what do you mean by that? See here. First of all, why it is called linear? It's called linear because see, in the problem, all the terms are linear. See here, x1 raised to 1, x2 raised to 1, x3 raised to 1, and so on. All the terms here are linear. Linear means power should be 1. We also have one more chapter, that is non-linear programming problems. In that case, you will be getting something like this. Let's say the whole square, x1 square, x1 cube, and so on. But this is your linear programming problem. So all the terms are linear. So what is the main objective of this particular chapter? See, this is called objective function and these are called constraints. This is called your objective function. Maximize z is equal to, this is called objective function and these are called our constraints. See, my what is my aim? My aim is to maximize the value of z. See, how I can maximize the value of z? By putting the values of x1, x2 and x3, I can maximize the value of z. But what value I can put here, x1, x2, x3, it depends upon the constraint. That means I want to maximize the value of z and there are two constraints involved. Generally, in practical, maximize means what? Generally, we want to maximize the profit. So suppose z is my profit and I want to maximize it. And suppose these are the inputs. And minimize also possible. So what do you mean by minimize? We want to reduce the cost. So generally, when it is maximized, we assume it's a profit that should be maximized. And if the problem is of minimization type, generally, we assume it's a cost that should be minimized. So let us move on and let us discuss what needs to be done in the first problem. This is your basic type problem. Determine the basic solution to the following problem. This is the problem. We need to determine its basic solution. Also check whether the solution that we got is a feasible or not, optimal or not. Investigate the solution is degenerate or non-degenerate. So basically, these are the things asked. First of all, we need to find it out the solution, basic solution, so that we'll get it here. We need to check that solution is feasible or not, optimal or not, degenerate or not. So these are the different things that we need to calculate. For that purpose, we need to understand this definition. So definitions are given here. You can copy this definition. First of all, basic feasible solution. If a basic solution satisfies the non-negative restriction, then it is called basic feasible solution. And if all the values in basic feasible solutions are non-zero, then solution is called non-degenerate. These are the definition you can copy. Now we'll discuss this definition while solving the problem. This will be very clear while solving the problem. Okay, so let us start with the solution. See here, one more point that you need to remember. M is your number of variable and N is your number of constraints. So here, your number of variables. Check in the problem how many variables we have. We have 3 variables, so here m is equal to 3. How many constraints we have? This is called objective function and these two are my constraints. So here the constraints are 2. Therefore, you need to remember this line. Basic solution is obtained by putting m minus n, that is 3 minus 2, is equal to 1 variable as 0. See, for obtaining the basic solution, we need to put m minus n. M is 3, 3 minus 2, 1 variable as 0, that we'll see here shortly. And number of solutions are mcn, so that is 3c2, that is 3. So what do you mean by these two terms? So let us start. See here, basic solution is obtained. See, from this equation, we'll get the basic solution. From these equations, we'll get the basic solution. And Once we get the basic solution, we'll check whether it is a feasible, optimal, degenerate or non-degenerate. For obtaining this basic solution, we need to substitute m minus n, that is one variable, as zero. Now see, there are three variables. So number of solution possible are three. So this is my first solution, this is my second solution, this is my third solution. This we have already discussed. Number of solution means mcn. Now one variable we need to substitute at zero. Let's say this is x1, here x2 and x3. At a time you need to substitute one variable as zero. So let me substitute x1 0, x2 0, x3 0. If I substitute x1 0, that is my non-basic variable. Whichever variable we put as zero, that is called non-basic variable. So if x1 is non-basic variable, so what are the basic variables remaining two, that is x2 and x3. Here if x2 is non-basic, x1 and x3 remaining, x3, then it will be x1, x2. What will be the equation? See here, very simple. If I'll put x1 as 0, then what will be the equation? This substitution we need to put in the objective function, in the constraint. So x1 0 we putting, x2 0 we putting, x3 0 we substituting. Okay, so that we're going to put in the constraint, not in the objective function. We're going to put in the constraint. See here, if x1 is 0, so this is gone, you will be left with these two equations. So we'll getting 2x2, see here, 2x2, 3x3 equal to 7. Next, x1 I'm putting it 0, so I'll be getting 4x2 plus 6x3 is equal to 15. Now if you put these two equations in calculator, you will get no solution. You will get error, no solution. Why? See here, if you multiply first equation with 2, so this will become 4 and this will become 6, and the equation will be similar, 4 and 6, so you'll get no solution. Or you put in the calcium check, it will give you an error, so there is no solution possible. So let's move on. Now we'll substitute x2 is equal to 0. So if I put x2 is equal to 0, so this is 0, I'll get x1 plus 3x3 is equal to 7. See here, x1 plus 3x3 is equal to 7, 3x1 plus 3x1 plus 6x3 is equal to 15. Now if you put this two equation in calculator, we'll get x1 is equal to 1 and x3 is equal to 3. Obviously you can put in the calculator and check the result, you will get this solution. Let us move on and let us find it out the last. X3 you'll get it 2. Put in the calculator and check, x1 is 1 and x3 is 2. What is the last? X3 we need to put it as 0, that we're going to put in the constraint. So here x3 is 0, so we'll be getting x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 7. See here, if I'll put x3 is equal to 0, x1 plus 2x2 is equal to 7, 3x1 plus 4x2, 3x1 plus 4x2, this is 0, equal to 15. Again put these two equation in calculator and you'll get x1 as 1 and x2 as 3. We got the basic solution. See, we got the equation, and after solving the equation we got the basic solution. First of all let us check out of this basic solution which is feasible solution. So what is the definition of feasible solution? Definition is written here. The definition says all the values should be non-negative. That's it, all the values should be non-negative. See here, both the values, this is not a solution, so no need to check. It's no solution, basically it's not a proper solution, so obviously it can't be feasible solution, optimal solution, it's not a solution, so everywhere dash will come. See here, both the constraint are positive, therefore it's a feasible solution. What do you mean by feasible solution? Non-negative restriction, that means number should be positive. You can write it down, and in bracket you can write down all the numbers should be positive. That's it, zero will do, zero and positive. That should basically, the number should be greater than equal to 0. This is the meaning. So here 1 and 2 both are greater than equal to 0. 1 and 3 both are greater than equal to 0. Therefore it is also yes. Let us find it out the optimal solution. First of all, whether a solution is an optimal solution or not optimal solution, first of all, for that purpose we need to find the solution, then we can find it out the optimal solution. So let us divide this into two categories.
let us divide this further into two categories. First of all, let us find it out Z, and let us find it out optimal solution. See,
x1, here we are not finding any value x1, x2, x3, therefore dash, dash and dash will come. Now for this particular case, x2 is 0, x1 is 1 and x3 is 2. If I'll put all these values in the objective function, I'll get the value of Z. See here, what I'm saying, in place of x2, put 0. So if I'll put 0, this will be gone. In place of this x1, put 1. So this is 1. And in place of x3, put 2. So that will be 8 plus 1, 9. Z value will be 9. So here Z is equal to 9. Next, let us find it out a Z value for this particular case. Here x3 is 0, so x3 is gone. Next, x1 is 1 and x2 is 3. So this x1 is 1 and x2 is 3. So this will be minus 6 plus 1, that is minus 5. So this is the way we find the value of Z. Now next is optimal solution. Optimal solution definition is not given here, so you can write it down. I am dictating you. See, what is the definition? If the problem is of maximization type, problem may be maximize or minimize. If the problem is of maximization type, maximum value or bigger value is your optimal solution. See, there will optimal solution will be always one value. Okay, so if the problem is of maximization type, which is the larger value, that is your optimal value. And suppose the problem is of minimization type, so which is your smaller value is called optimal value. For example, here the problem is of maximize, therefore my optimal solution will be 9, and this is not my optimal solution. Suppose the same problem, the problem is of minimize. Now in this case, which value is small? This value is small, so that will become my optimal solution. In that case, it is no. So I hope this is clear. Finally, degenerate and non-degenerate. So definition is given here. All non-zero, non-degenerate. See here. All non-zero, non-degenerate. All non-zero, non-degenerate. See, remember this way. Non-zero, non-degenerate. Non-non. See here. Non-zero, both are non-zero, non-degenerate. Next. Again, both are non-zero, non-degenerate. So that is it. So this is your basic solution to this particular problem. Hope you understood. If you have any problem, watch this video 2-3 times. It will be very clear. In the next video also, we'll be discussing a similar problem. Thank you.